We interrupt this program for an important...
Yow!
Explain to me how to fix NAT type on Xbox One. I've heard that I should switch to NAT 1 to fix my slow connection problems.
If you switch to Type 1 NAT, also called the Open NAT, there's nothing between you and the connectivity.
I've heard Open NAT may be good if you cannot control all the other hardware settings that otherwise improve gameplay.
Like when you cannot alter outer settings, or set up a DMZ. Type 2 NAT is the most common NAT configuration, though, unless your ISP or parents are punishing you.
I do not know what NAT settings I have, but I need to know how to change them.
I do not recommend NAT 1 settings, because you have no firewall. If you think it is slow now, wait until it has a virus.
We're always at war with hackers, so I cannot go without some security.
You could put the Xbox One in the DMZ of the router, opening it up, without putting the rest of the home network at as much risk.
That still leaves the router itself open.
You can improve performance on the Xbox One, by making sure you have a static IP address for the console.
My internet service provider will not let me have a static IP address, unless I'm a business account.
You could set up port forwarding, though that requires accessing the administrative panel on the router, and assigning a DHCP reservation, or static IP address to the console.
Which is in the manual.
Or on Google's search results, if you look up port forwarding plus the router model number. And if you want multiple ports involved, like for different games or users, research port triggering.
That's a long list, because there are a lot of different games, even different ports for chatting, Skype, Kinect and matchmaking.
Let's say you've entered the port information, for port forwarding or port triggering. Set the network information to manual, so the router does what it is supposed to do.
And I do not destroy the connection via a typo.
You still need to test the connection, which you can do via test multiplayer connection. When it connects, hold down LT plus RB plus RT on the controller, to get the NAT status.
That sounds like an Easter egg in a video game.
Once it starts loading the detailed NAT status, it should update with one of the better NAT types. If you cannot do that, try UPnP.
That's Universal Plug and Play.
You can try to assign UPnP to the Xbox One, though it only works if it has a static IP address. Read the manual for information on how to do that with the router.
Sounds like port forwarding is the best solution for me.